This is Jeff Myers. I'm president of Summit Ministries in Colorado. In my book, Unquestioned Answers, I tackle 10 cliches that keep Christians' faith at a shallow level. One of them you probably have heard and have enjoyed. It's when the pastor stands up and says, God is good, and the people reply, all the time. And then the pastor says, all the time, and the people shout, God is good. I think we should reconsider saying that. Not because it's untrue, it is biblical, but because people's pain is real, and we need something more than just a hearty cheer for our tribe to deal with it. Specifically, the young adults I work with all want to know, how could a good God allow evil? I've asked that myself. Recently, my wife suffered from a very rare blood clot in her brain that nearly took her life. I asked God, why? We've loved you. We've served you. What is going on? Maybe you've suffered. Maybe the death of a loved one or a divorce, or maybe the uncertainty of the world that just causes unbearable fear and anxiety. Here are four brief ways you can talk with your kids about evil from God's perspective. I should mention, those who don't believe in God have a harder time explaining good and evil than Christians do. After all, if there is nothing outside of this world, then there's no such thing as ultimate good. Anything bad that happens is just tough luck. As Richard Dawkins puts it, DNA neither knows nor cares. DNA just is, and we dance to its music. There's nothing encouraging there. Other worldviews ignore evil and suffering altogether. Worldviews like some forms of Buddhism believe that if we deny that suffering is real, it will go away. But that makes people feel that their suffering is somehow their own fault. It makes them feel even worse about what they're going through. The Bible doesn't deny that bad things happen. Things that maybe even make us want to question God. Sometimes Christians in the Bible are called to endure suffering, as we see with the apostles. Other times, God's people are very direct about their suffering. Jeremiah 12:1 asks, why does the way of the wicked prosper? Psalm 13:2, David implores God, how long must I cry out? The whole book of Job is about the suffering of an innocent man. He's not rebellious. He just wants to know why. And God never tells him why. Here are four principles about a biblical worldview of good and evil that you can share very simply with your children if you just remember these four words: puppet, rust, app, and missionary. First point, God is a director. Picture a marionette puppet to remember this point. God does not dangle us like puppets from strings. Rather, he directs us as in a play. He works everything out so that when we arrive at where our free choices take us, we will see that he has been there all along. As Romans 8:28 puts it, God works all things to the good. Remember puppet. Second, God didn't make evil. The Bible says in Genesis 1:28 that God made everything good. He didn't just make good things. He made the very idea of good itself. So where does evil come from? I want you to picture a rusty car to remember this point. Evil is a corruption or a cancer on what is good. Evil is to good what rust is to a car. You don't so much see the rust as you see the damage that the rust has done. You don't so much see the evil as much as you see what has been eaten away from, what should be there that's not. That's what God said was good. Third, God made us free. Think of an app that you can program. Let's say you knew how to do this. You designed your own app, an app that would wake you up every morning by saying, I love you. Does that app really love you? Of course not. It's only saying, I love you because you told it to. God created a dynamic world in which we would be free to love him and to do good. But for us to really love him and do good, we had to be able to choose. We couldn't be robots. We couldn't just be apps that were programmed. In a world that's rusting away, we may end up using God's good creation to do bad things. We can use God's stones to build things, but we can also throw them at people and cause injury. We can use water to sustain life, but people can also suffer from floods and drowning. Fourth thing to remember, God calls us to act. Because God made everything good, we have the freedom to do good. Every believer is a missionary who shares God's good news and stands for truth and fights against evil and injustice. God designed us to act. God made us free to act. God gave us the power to act. So let's act. The missionaries of the future won't just be Bible teachers. They'll be healing bodies, leading peace negotiations, protecting people from natural disasters, fighting tyranny, growing economies, battling pollution, prosecuting crime, spreading technology and education, and doing all of it in Jesus' name. So remember, puppet, God directs us as in a play rather than dangling us like puppets. Rust. God made good, not evil. We know evil is there because it eats away at what is good. App. God made us free so we could want to love him and do what he says. And missionary. We are called to act on what is good in Jesus' name, becoming the missionaries of the future, no matter what we do for a living. In the end, God's answer to pain and suffering isn't an argument, it's a person. It's Jesus. Bad things happen, but we know from the Bible, I think Revelation 21:5, that Jesus is making all things new. Every day is a gift in which we have an opportunity to say yes to Jesus and to do all of the good that he shows us to do.